How do we have a bicolor LED show up red when there's no power and green when there is power? Watch and you'll find out. I'm Tom Kovichak and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And in a previous video, I showed you how to use a 3-pin bicolor LED to signify whether you had power off or on a track. Now today I'm going to show you how to use a 2-pin bicolor LED to do the same thing. It's a little less wiring. It has 3 resistors instead of 2, and you only need 2 wires off of your switch instead of 3. So right after this, we'll show you how to do it. If you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell. And that'll notify you whenever I have a new video coming out. I have videos coming out on Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday, so take a look for them. In our previous video with the 3-pin bicolor LED, we used 2 resistors. Now in this one, with the 2-pin bicolor LED, we're going to use 3 resistors and only 2 pins on the switch. On the old one, we used 3 pins. And on this one, we just have to cut the power to it like that. And I'm going to do it with a push button, but I'll also show you how to do it with a double pole, double throw switch. And you're only going to need 2 pins on it for the 2-pin bicolor LED. The first thing we're going to need to do is cut 3 resistors off of here. So we're just going to take these and snip them off. Okay, according to our diagram, we need 1 resistor off of the negative and 1 resistor off of the positive. We'll take this and just bend it down like this. So we could have that. Okay. Now on this other one, we're going to do the same thing. Bend it down. And on the other one, the same thing. We just bend it down. And now we trim them off. Trim off a little bit of the excess. I'm going to keep just one, just a little bit longer than the other. That way we could guide one in first, get it in place, and then work the other one around it. Like I said, we're going to take one off the negative and one off the positive, and I'm going to work over here and go like this and bring it over there. That's off the positive. Now we're going to take one off the negative, but we're going to move it down just a little bit over here so we have room to work with. Okay. So now we got these 2 resistors in here, right here. Now we're going to have another one off the negative that goes directly to one side of the diode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it up here a little bit. And I'm going to bring it up just about, I'll bring it up 3 away. Okay. And you can see 2 of them are off of the negative, and then 1 of them is off of the positive. I made up a little jumper right here, and we're going to put it between those 2 resistors. Okay, this resistor and right there and there, we're coming off the negative and positive, and that has the same potential right there. So we're going to put this little jumper in right here. And so that makes that end of that resistor and that end of this resistor right here. So off of that, we're going to put the LED. When placing your LED, just make sure that when your switch is open, you have the red one lit. Okay, so one side of the LED goes to the other resistor, which is this one right here. So what we might want to do here is move this resistor over just a little bit to be on the other side. So we'll move this over to where it says 13 and put that right there. On that side, we need the switch. So we'll put one side of this switch on the same line as the resistor and the LED. And then the other side of the switch has to go to the positive. So we need to bring a jumper from this side to the positive bus, and we'll be all set. And we'll go on the positive bus, and we can do that anywhere, right here. And we'll put it on this side of the resistor, or not the resistor, but the switch. Now, what we're going to do, since we don't know the exact value of this LED, because there was no documentation with it. It just came in a plastic bag, just like this. And it doesn't tell you anything on it. I could go on the website for the manufacturer and find out, but we're already at this point right here. Now I gotta turn my strip on and I'll turn this on. Now I had that on 3.3 volts. Now that might not have been enough going through the 100 ohm resistors to get light on the LED. So I put it on 5 volt and we'll turn that on. Okay, so now with the 5 volt, you can see that with no power, because the power has to come through this switch, and when we hit this switch right here, it's going to turn green. This is the principle that I'm showing you here, that you have current coming even with this push button right here, or even with this switch. We can make that switch look like this. Okay, this push button right here, and then this is the double pull, double throw switch. Now, right now, there's no power on it because we're going through right here to there and here to here. Okay, and then when we flip the switch over, it brings it down to here. I'll just put a dashed line here, and that's like hitting the push button right there. Now, the principle behind this is we have current going through one of the LEDs through here. We're going from the plus through this way and over, and then the negative through this way on this side. So we're lighting up the red. So when there's nothing on the switch, we have current going this way and coming down and then back through to and up through here. When we push the switch, okay, we're taking the easier route. We're going this way through here, up around and through that switch to the positive. Now, since this is an LED, current only travels in one direction. So we could do this with the three resistors here, making it so when there's no power to our track that we want to simulate on our track, on our engine facility, the switch is off. But when we push the button here, it turns green. That's when we turn the toggle switch down. That's when we switch positions on the toggle switch. Now remember, on this one right here, we used three wires on that. But on here, on this one here, this is just like using just two of the posts on here. We only need part of the switch for that. And remember, the other half of this double pull, double throw switch is going to our track. So we could use half of this for the track and half of this switch for our LED. Coming up in another episode, we're going to tackle the problem about the gaps in the reversing loop on a DC layout. So we're going to use LEDs on there so we can make sure that we have the correct direction as we're going from one gap, from one block to the next block over top of a gap, so we don't have the power reversed. We could have a visual indication showing that we have the same direction as we're going through from one block to the other. And then we'll have to stop, change the direction to match the other one, and then go through the next block. So that's coming up soon. And if you're interested in YouTube, check out Tom Kvitchak, the channel there that I just started. We'll see you. Bye-bye.